Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
In this video, we will analyze and design main cable of pedestrian suspension bridge. Consider simple suspension pedestrian bridge. Deck of bridge hang freely with two main cables with help of series of hanger ropes. Cable is connected with left and right posts. We will determine maximum tension force in cable and reaction forces acting at the post. Bridge has length of 80 feet and width of 3.25 feet. Distance from bridge deck to top of the bridge post is 12 feet. Each main cable has maximum sag of 10 feet. Let's assume total weight of bridge deck is 20 kip. This weight is supported by two main cables, so each cable carry load of 10 kip. Since bridge length is 80 feet, so uniformly distributed dead load on each cable is 10 divided by 80, which is 0.125 kip per foot. Bridge will design to sustain live load of 0.1 kip per foot square. Each main cable will carry half of live load, that will be 0.1 multiplied by 3.25 divided by 2 equals to 0.1625 kip per foot. Total uniform distributed load on cable will be dead load plus live load equals to 0.2875 kip per foot. We can assume cable connected to post as pin connection. Let's draw a free body diagram of structure. Since we have pin end cables, we have two unknown forces at each point A and B. Note down coordinates of system. We place origin of structural system at lowest point of cable. Let's cut section of cable from its lowest point. Free body diagram looks like this. T0 is tension force in cable at its lowest point. We have resultant force of UDL equals to 0.2875 multiplied with 40 equals to 11.5 kip. Acting at center of UDL, that is 20 feet from point C and B also. We have three unknown variables to determine using equilibrium equations. Summation of moment at point B equals to 0, that is T0 into 10 minus 11.5 into 20 equals to 0, in which T0 is making counterclockwise movement and 11.5 kip force is making clockwise movement. Solving this and result of T0 equals to 23 kip. Summation of forces in x direction equals to 0, that is Bx equals to T0. Summation of forces in y direction equals to 0, that is By minus resultant force of UDL, which is 11.5 equals to 0. Result of By equals to 11.5 kip. Now using reaction forces at B, we can determine reaction forces at A using equilibrium equations. Resultant of UDL force, which is 0.2875 kip per foot multiply 80 feet equals to 23 kip. Summation of forces in x direction equals to 0, that is Ax minus Bx equals to 0. Summation of forces in y direction equals to 0, that is Ay plus By minus resultant of UDL force, which is 23 equals to 0. Input value of By in equation and result of Ay equals to 11.5 kip. Now let's determine maximum tension force in cable. For that, let's cut cable from low point to near point of left support, such that we have x is horizontal distance and y is vertical distance between these points. We can determine horizontal and vertical components of tension force at cut point using equilibrium equations. Summation of forces in x direction equals to 0, therefore Tx equals to 23 kip. Summation of forces in y direction equals to 0, therefore Ty equals to 0.2875x. We can determine tension force T using Pythagoras theorem. T square equals to Tx square plus Ty square. Input values of Tx and Ty in equation, we have tension force T equals to square root of 23 square plus 0.2875x square. Above equation shows that maximum tension force in cable attains when x reaches its maximum value. So we have maximum x equals to 40 feet. Input this value of x in tension force T equation, we get T equals to 25.7 kip, which is maximum tension force in cable. Now let's design this main cable of pedestrian suspension bridge using AISC LRFD and AISC ASD codes. In AISC LRFD, we have PU equals to 1.45 into load. We are using 1.45 factor with service load. Since we have analyzed cable using service load in which dead load and live load both was exist, better to analyze cable as dead load and live load separately and then use combination of 1.2 dead load plus 1.6 live load. So we have PU equals to 37.26 kip. As we know that cable area required in LRFD equals to PU over phi into 0.75 into FU, where phi is resistance factor and equals to 0.75. FU is ultimate tensile strength, and for A36 grade steel, FU equals to 58 KSI. Input all values in formula, result of AB equals to 1.14 inch square. Using number 10 cable, which is 10 by 8 or 1.25 inch diameter cable having an area of 1.22 inch square. In AISC ASD, we have PA equals to 1.0 into load, that is 25.7 kip. As we know that area required in ASD equals to omega into PA over 0.75 into FU, where omega is safety factor in ASD and equals to 2. FU equals to 58 KSI, input all values in formula, result of AB equals to 1.18 inch square. Using number 10 cable, which is 10 by 8 or 1.25 inch diameter cable having an area of 1.22 inch square. Now let's analyze this cable in SAP 2000. Go to file and click on new model. Set unit to kip fit. Click on blank. Right click on window and click on edit grid data. Click on modify show system. Since we have bridge length of 80 feet defining grid in x of 80 feet, we will not use y grid data and z grid data. Go to define and click on materials. Click on add new material. Select material type to steel. Standard ASTM A36 and grade 36 steel. Go to define section properties and click on cable sections. Click on add new section. Now defining number 10 steel cable having diameter of 1.25 inch which has area of 1.22 inch square. Click on OK. Go to define and click on load patterns. Change self weight multiplier of dead load to 0. So that SAP 2000 will not take section self-weight during analyzing. Click on OK. Go to draw, draw frame cable tendons. Select line object type to cable. When you click for second cable joint, a menu table of cable open. Select cable maximum vertical sag in cable type. Input maximum vertical sag value of 10 feet, as in our case sagging of cable is 10 feet. Note down cable length exceed to 83.4 feet. Click on OK. Cable as drawn with vertical sag of 10 feet. Select joints A1 and B1. Go to assign joints and click on restraints. Select pin joint to assign. Select cable. Go to assign cable load and click on distributed. Input uniform load to 0.2875 kip per foot. Click on OK. Go to analyze and click on run analysis. These are joint reaction forces. Minor difference in result with hand calculation is due to cable length, as SAP 2000 is taking full cable length with 10 feet sag effect in cable also. Go to display, show forces, stresses, and click on frame cable tendons. Now look, maximum tension force of 26.342 kip near to joint same as we calculated using equilibrium equations. At lowest cable point, there is lowest tension force of 23.579 kip, same as we get using equilibrium equations. Hope you like my video. Do like, share and comment below in comment section. Also subscribe and press bell icon so you will never miss any update. If you need any assistance in structural engineering design of structures, you can contact me through email address. There is email through which you contact me. Also, you can suggest me videos to be made.